How's it going, Bruce? Welcome back to whatever this, I've forgotten. Litter. Last answer. I'm not drunk, I promise. Anyway, what were we doing? I forgot. Let's just talk to this man, shall we? He wasn't here the last few times we came in here. Nozu was. And he's the one who keeps kicking ass out, so maybe we'll get lucky. I swear I'm not drunk. Swear to God. Did something happen? His family ran a famous construction company in Matsue called Nozuichi Construction. So he's from a wealthy family. I swear I'm not drunk. Maybe I'm having a stroke. I hear he used to live in the lap of luxury. Oh yeah? If I die on stream, this video is going to go up and, well, I mean, no one's going to edit it, are they? But, you know, and just in case someone puts it up, it'll alert the authorities. It's probably been like 2 weeks since I had the stroke, and I'm very, very dead now. But, you know, the house is going to smell. But his life changed in the summer of his third year of high school. The authorities found out that Nozuichi Construction had been illegally cutting corners. Literally. Out there with a fucking saw, just cutting the corners off. His father was arrested and the company went bankrupt. He was plunged into poverty overnight. But none of it was his fault, right? No, but the public didn't see it that way. Well, that's enough for me. I'll come by later for a drink. I leave the bar. He's so much nicer than Nozu. Can he run the bar? I think about Nozu. I'm pretty sure the bartender is shorty. But was he that short? I mean, people grow, right? I'll try going to ask Bitch one more time. Fuck, I'll never get used to that. Where's Bitch? At Waterworks, being a bitch, or at the Usagi Theatre Company, being a bitch? Not here, I guess. I wonder if they're here by now. The theatre children are practicing. Bitch isn't here. Oh, what a bitch. If the children are here, does that mean Bitch is at Waterworks? No, because I was just there. So if she was there, I should have run into her when I was here. I arrive at Waterworks. You and your having to hit the specific flags to move on thing. Frustrating. I step inside. I'll try asking the manager. Excuse me. May I help you? Riko Haneda? Is Riko Sasaki here? She's in the back. When I try to head for a seat at the back, Bitch comes over. I'm not talking to you anymore. Good plan. Come on, quit saying that and tell me about the bartender at the Nakamoto Bar. No. Are we done pestering everybody else? Like Four Eyes and Monkey? Instead we're gonna pester this lady over and over again. Shorty is the bartender, isn't he? If you follow me around anymore, I'll report you to the police. That's a good plan. Don't do that. Stay away from me. Got it? Bitch says forcefully and returns to her seat by the other mothers. Why won't anyone talk to me? What fucking planet do you live on, son? Why won't anyone talk to me? Because you're a total asshole. Why won't anyone talk to me? I'm so fucking oblivious of my own assholery. What the fuck is wrong with you? Who the fuck am I controlling? Patrick Star? Mr. Bean? Who the fuck am I? What? Oh god, okay. I mean, at least I got a laugh out of it, right? Sorry for not ordering anything. I'll come back for a coffee next time. It's not that. Just now, were you talking about Nozu of the Nozuichi Construction? Do you know something? I don't know if you'd call it knowing something, but it's about the big scandal. Did the son of Nozuichi Construction frequent this place too? He was a notorious prodigal son. How was he after his father when was arrested? I haven't seen him recently, but I heard he's living humbly with his mother. He lives alone with his mother, huh? How tall was he? He was pretty short. And it seems he doesn't like water. He's got rabies. You mean he doesn't like drinking water? No, I mean he can't swim. Neither. I heard when he was a child he fell from a boat and nearly drowned. The man who was following me didn't get on the tour boat. Could he have been shorty? Except he was pretty tall. Thanks. Yeah? Has the son of Nozuichi Construction returned to Matsui? He's a bartender at the Nakamura's. Why do you ask? My friend had their house done by Nozuichi Construction and had a terrible experience. I see. It's my friend, but Nozu's father was the one at fault. The son didn't have anything to do with it. Please at least understand that. I leave Waterworks. Surely he understands that. He can't be as much of a twat and an asshole as we are. One crime can make a lot of people unhappy, I guess. It looks like Shorty was notorious around here. I'll try heading up Marukoshi next. Shorty probably went there when he was in high school. Have I heard of that place already? There's a lot of places on my map, and I don't know. Oh, there it is. Have I been here before? I must have been. Oh yeah, I vaguely remember. I arrive at Marukoshi. A middle-aged woman comes out. Ma'am? When she turns around, I realize it's not the manager. Me? Sorry, I thought you were someone else. If you're looking for the manager, she's inside. She gives a slight bow and walks off. I wonder who that was. A customer? It's a shop. Sorry. When I go inside, the manager is there with the young man I've seen before. That's the punk who tried to threaten me. You. Are you waiting around to attack me? Hey, it's you from the other day. Hiroshi, what did you do this time? I didn't do nothing. You tried to attack me. Hiroshi, is that true? I had my reasons. You mean yes. Ma'am, how do you know this guy? He's the child of a friend and I look after him like a son. Hiroshi, is that story true? Well, I'm sorry he caused you trouble. This was a guy thing. You know, those guy things. Those excuses won't work on me. Who told you to attack me? Hurry up and tell him. You know I have a short temper. This lady is someone else when she gets angry. It was my bro, Nozu. What did he tell you to do? To threaten you and make it so you'd leave town. Becoming an underling for a guy like that, what a disgrace. He told me he'd let me drink for free and... Young man, I'm sorry this fool did you such a cowardly thing. Please forgive him. That's fine. Why can't you tell me about the bartender? There's no need to feel obligated to ask about a guy like that. What is it you want to hear, young man? Was the bartender called Shorty? Yeah, that's right. But he's not short. It's because he's always wearing shoes. Everybody's always wearing shoes. Shoes? I mean, I'm not wearing shoes right now, but I'm inside. They're his secret shoes. It was something that simple, huh? Hiroshi, we got that CD. We should let him hear it. I was gonna say, who was so worried about their height that they'd wear like stilts instead of like just being normal? But then again, I thought about the people that like get their leg bones cut and then extra bits of bone put in so they're not short. Which sounds fucking insane. But I'm not short, so I don't know. And actually, we've got that CD. We should let him hear it. That? I don't know. What is it? He's got quite the singing voice. Singing voice? He recorded a song on CD. He said it was going to be a present to a girl he liked. He made me help him record, so I have the CD. If you let me borrow that, I'll forget everything that happened between us. Okay, fine. Hiroshi brings over a CD that was in the shop. It's pretty embarrassing. I'll be careful with it. I take the CD. Embarrassing for Nozu, not for you. It's about time for the weather forecast. Have you seen Nozu lately? Nope. I hadn't even heard he was back. I guess not that many people know he works at the bar. I suppose it's to be expected, though. Hiroshi seems to know, but it doesn't look like he's been told to keep it a secret. Of course he knows. He got this... He was told to attack us. By him. When I stop to think about it, the bartender seems to have been pretty tough, too. Are you close with the bartender? Not exactly close, but my bro has always been looking out for me, so... How can you say you're not close and call him your bro? Even before he started working at the bar, he'd always stop by whenever he was in the area. And he has it together more than I thought, even just for keeping the bar clean. Should I go? I should ask Snappy about the bartender this time. She might be doing a broadcast at the castle. She might be. Who knows? Oh my god, she actually is. Shocking. How did we know that? Is it because we're psychic? Maybe. Okay, I'm trying to stop being so fucking sarcastic all the time. I'm sorry. I'm trying, okay? I'm not trying, but I'll try now. I'll try now. I'm not guaranteed I'm gonna keep it up though. I arrive at Shirayama Park. There's a TV broadcast. Oh my god, we were right. Oh my god, I did it again. There's a TV broadcast going on and Snappy is reading the weather forecast. The TV broadcast concludes. Snappy notices me. You're waiting for me again, huh? Sure. Do you always read the weather forecast here? No matter how much you dig around, nobody's gonna talk to you about it. I'm thinking of asking the bartender some questions next. That's seriously dangerous, you know. Snappy looks around. What happened? You're being followed. When I look around, I notice the man in the cap in the shadows of the building. It's obviously Nozu, isn't it, dickhead? Is that the bartender? It's not a great disguise, but that's him. I mean, it's not a great disguise, so obviously that's him. In that case, I'll go talk to him myself. You can't. Stop. That guy's planning to attack me, right? If he wants a fight, I'll fight him here. The castle makes a nice backdrop for a brawl. Can we do swords? Do you want to play swords? I got a text from him yesterday. Whatever you do, don't provoke him. He's got a gun? That's not fair. We should be playing swords. What do the texts say? That he'd shut you up by force if necessary. He does have swords. Interesting. I glance at the man in the cap. He throws a fucking boomerang at me or a yo-yo. Let's call for the help so we won't commit any crimes. Is there anyone who would help? There's someone who'll help if I ask for it. Looks like the Sanakake Baba sand is actually pepper. There's one more, isn't there? Ah, the wild monkey. He's not wild, he's just monkey. When I look over, the man in the cap grins. It'd be dangerous to leave you alone, but I have to go back to the station first. I'll be somewhere he can't touch me. Where? Around the castle. I nod to Snappy. Snappy stares intently at the man in the cap. What? Nothing. Do you have something you want to say to that guy or what? It's alright. I'll hold off for now. Snappy goes back to the station. Well, that was weird. Maybe she had something she wanted to tell me about the man in the cap. She get away from here or else that guy will attack me. No word from Monkey yet, huh? I'm just circling the moat to buy time. When I look back, the man in the cap who has disappeared. I move someplace with more bystanders. As I start walking, the man in the cap appears again. What's going on here? I wonder if there's a place where I can buy time without being followed. I'm getting worn out from walking around. Maybe I should see about getting a ride. The boat? What's a good way to buy time? I don't know. Looks like a cafe. The storefront is covered in posters for local stuff. I guess I'm not meant to be doing that. Getting a ride. Guidebook? There's a tour boat boarding. Yeah, that's where I was gonna go. At the meeting park. Being rocked on a tour boat for a while wouldn't be so bad. I'm sure I don't need to worry about him attacking if there are other people around. Can I go now? Okay. I arrive at the boarding area. We've been here before. Why is it new on the map? I'll buy time on a tour boat until Monkey gets here for backup. Or was that in a flashback thing? I board the tour boat. The man in the cap is at the boarding area. He turns around and leaves without boarding the boat. It seems he hasn't conquered his fear of water. The skipper launches the boat. Oh good. That guy was in front of the Matsue Inn too. I bet he was also the one who went through my stuff. So he was looking for Aya's letters, huh? I lose myself in thought and suddenly realize a change in my surroundings. The roof of the boat is lowered. The boat passes under 16 bridges of different heights, so it lowers its roof for low bridges. I'll kick back and enjoy the tour boat for a while. I look out at the scenery. This is nice. A text comes in on my cell phone. Huh, a text. I get out my phone to check the message. I'll be waiting at the Otamachi Park, so get off the tour boat there, Monkey. Okay. I text back. If Monkey is there, surely he won't commit any crimes. Now I just need to figure out how to get him to tell the truth. The boat pulls up to the boarding area. It looks like we've arrived. I step off the boat. A number of passengers get off, and a few people who are waiting get on. I look around. Yes, Monkey isn't here yet. He just said he was here. The tour boat leaves. The sun sets as I wait at the boarding area. He's late. Wait, is this not the place? I reread the text. It says you'll be waiting at Otamachi Park. I look at the boarding area. Shoot, this is Curator Park. Oh, we're an idiot, I see. Where is Otamachi Park? I'll try looking for it in the guidebook. That's what I tried to click, I'm sorry. I check the guidebook. It's not too far to walk from here. When I look around, the man in the cap is there. Shit, he found me. I hurry away. I'm hurrying down the street with the man just behind. Those elevator shoes slow him down, I guess. I keep looking back as I walk. How do I get to Otamachi Park? Guidebook? I keep going straight, huh? I walk on. The man in the cap jumps out from the street ahead. Crap, he went ahead of me. Ah! I try to make a run for it, but I twist my ankle and fall. The man in the cap stands over me. You're the bartender, aren't you? The man in the cap pulls a knife out of his pocket. This is seriously bad. You didn't listen to my warnings. This is your own fault. The man in the cap raises his knife. How am I supposed to fight him off? Is this really the time for that? I'm gonna save, because I always fuck these up anyway. As you're well aware, I'm sure, at this point. We're how many episodes in now? Time for a think. Do I have anything with me that I can use to fight him off? Yes, I have a rocket launcher in my pocket. A rocket in my pocket. Pepper! Go! Take this! I fling the Tsunekage Baba sand at the man in the cap. It says pepper on it. I give him a face full of pepper. The man in the cap falters. Ah, pepper, my one weakness. Now's my chance to escape. I get to my feet. You're not getting away. The man in the cap brandishes his knife. Well, I mean, if I did, it'd be embarrassing for you, wouldn't it? Beaten by a guy with a fucking container of pepper. You have a knife, I have a thing of pepper, and I win? Loser. Hey, stop. When the man's cap falls off, I can see that it's the bartender. It's the bartender! It's you, I knew it. It's your fault. The bartender swings around his knife in desperation. Hey, calm down. The bartender charges at me. You idiot, keep away. I make a run for it. The bartender is rushing at me in a terrible fury. Watch out. Whoa. Huh? Where the heck did he go? It's like he vanished. That was close. Monkey had sprung out from the sidelines and sent the bartender flying. Ow! The fallen bartender has lost one of his elevator shoes and he dropped the knife. Don't go waving around a goddamn knife. Snappy comes over and picks up the knife. Snappy, you came too? Why are you in a back alley like this? I accidentally got off at Curator Park. He jumped me on the way to Otamachi Park. Sounds like max stupidity. Damn it, whose side are you on? We just don't want to become a criminal. You of all people should know what it feels like when one of your own becomes a criminal. Snappy, Monkey. Thanks. He and I need to have a talk now. Alright, but also, do you have a CD player? What are you gonna do? I'm gonna humiliate him in front of his friends. Can we do that? I have a CD I want to listen to. I've got one in my car that we can use for cheering on the baseball team. I'll bring it over. Monkey goes to get the CD player. Alright, time to pull myself together and see what Shorty has to say. Save. Sorry, I'm gonna save, like, regularly after every interaction, because I'm an idiot, you know? He probably won't give me any answers if I just ask him. First, I need a pretext for bringing up his story. What the fuck does that mean? What do you mean by that? Can I just try to show the photo at him? Who was pretending to be Aya Fumino? Hell if I know. That's funny. In her letter, she wrote about Shorty. That doesn't mean it's me. Shorty's a pretty common nickname, is it? I have to prove that he's the Shorty mentioned in Aya's letters before I can get any further. The owner, Mr. Nakamura, told me about what the bartender used to be like. I'll try bringing that up. Okay. What I heard from the owner about your past matches what's in the letter. No idea. Here, the CD player. I'll ask you one last time. You really didn't know her? I'm telling you, I don't know. Have you got any proof that I know her? Am I gonna play the CD now? Mikey brought me the CD player. Now all the preparations are complete. Oh, cringe. Who'd you make this for? I play the CD Hiroshi lent me. Nozu's voice comes from the CD player. It's totally off key. Doesn't sound that bad to me. I stopped the CD. This is your voice, isn't it? So what? Alright, time to humiliate him properly. You're tone deaf! You're completely tone deaf. You can't understand the greatness of this piece. What on earth do you usually listen to? Okay, we're just gonna try them all like usual. I mean, we don't lose anything for fucking it up this time. So that's nice. Alright. It's not one and it's not four. Isn't it embarrassing? You're embarrassed, aren't you? It doesn't sound like it. I don't know what you're talking about. What's there to be embarrassed about? It's a great song. I'm a genius. So he's the narcissistic type, huh? When I look to my side, Monkey and Snappy both shake their heads. He's max mode at the wrong moment. You made me do it. Are we done? No, I've still got questions for you. And that's a stupid superpower. It's stupid. It's not a real superpower. Max mode is not a superpower. Being a mega asshole is your superpower, and I don't like it. That's a shitty superpower. I've still got questions for you. I'm running out of cards to play. Well, that's not a hint. Do you understand what a hint is? Because that's not one. I can guarantee that. That is not one. His mother? You live alone with your mother, don't you? Here we go. Okay, there must be something in my inventory I need to use, right? This? I don't know what you want from me, man. I got so much bullshit I'm carrying around. Nothing. We need to find the right one and then reload. Otherwise, I'm fucked. Dang. Ask. Okay, we found it. Nozu, in high school, you sent her a text message about how you loved her, didn't you? What are you saying? Judging from your reaction, it looks like I was right. The message was, my gaze is for real. Let's spark. You accidentally sent that text to me. Did I? Wait, that's what you're embarrassed about? Still, that doesn't prove I'm shorty. First of all, I'm not short. Alright, I have to reload. I'm gonna reload now. And we'll go through that bit again, but quickly, right? So I can get all my hearts back. That one. Alright, think. I'm not short, huh? You just dug your own grave. Safe. Sorry, if there was more like logic to it and it was less just taking guesses. I probably wouldn't say between each one, but it just feels like a guess for the most part. Oh, the shoe. You're wearing shoes like stilts. I pick up the elevator shoe he lost. I mean, he must be short now, because he's not wearing one of the shoes unless he's standing on one foot with the other one in the air all the time. In which case, skills. Respect. Shut up. If you take off your shoes, Shorty is a perfect nickname for you. What'd you say? I said you're a little short stack, motherfucker. Come at me. It's not like I was wearing these because I didn't like being short, okay? I love being short. It's my favorite. Why are you wearing elevator shoes? That's because... Save. I apologize. This is how it's gonna be, okay? What? The bartender what? The bartender called himself a man of the shadows, didn't he? Oh yes, he's the man of the shadows. He's a ghost. How does that help me? What the fuck does that mean to help me? It's gotta be one of these, right? It's not your short height that you want to hide, it's the fact that you're the son of Nozu Ichi Construction. Now, what does that got to do with being a man of the shadows? The elevator shoes were disguised to disguise yourself. No, the shoes have nothing to do with the company. Are we done here? I'm sick and tired of having you outsiders criticize my personal life. I think I'm wearing him down. Hey, the skin on his ankle is scraped up a bit. Quick, kick him in the ankle. Hey, those shoes don't seem to be fitting you correctly. The skin on your ankle is scraped. It's your fault, scurrying around like that. These aren't made for exercise. If I walk a lot, they cause blisters. Looks painful. You okay? Not as painful as the knife was about to be when he stabbed me in the face. I'm fine. When that guy took the boat, I went after him and took the next boat. I get to rest a bit then, so it doesn't hurt. Something's off. Isn't he lying? He's afraid of fucking water. You didn't actually ride the boat, did you? Huh? When you were a kid, you fell off a boat, right? You nearly drowned. And ever since, you've been frightened of water. Can't even ride a tour boat. Pathetic. What? Sorry, I'm mocking you. That's all. Lastly, I'll try telling him that. You're a twat and I hate you. I mean, no. Your mum wears combat boots. What do you want me to say? I'm going to save again. Something about his mum, right? We gotta put down his mum, that's the best way to get to someone. It's true. It seems you live alone with your mother. What the fuck has that got to do with anything? Leave mama out of this. Well, mama? At your age? Monkey and Snappy laughed softly. Mama is mama. What's so funny about that? That's her name. Her name is actually Mama. Mama Nozu. Shorty's mentally weak. Now's the time for max mode. He's not the only one who's mentally weak around here. If you're Japanese, say mother. A grown man should say mother. Shut up. At least call him mum. That's for me to decide. It'd be bad if he gets angry. Okay. You may act tough, but you're still a rich brat, aren't you? Shut up. I can report all the stuff you did to the police. I haven't done anything. Violation of the gun and sword law? Assault? Even breaking and entering? If we check the security cameras at the inn. That inn doesn't have security cameras. So you're pretty familiar with the inn I'm staying at. Shit. Condemn the crime, not the person? Okay, whatever. Next. We'll soak your pillow in tears. What the fuck? Yeah, man. I'll soak the pillow in your mum's blood. If you get arrested, I bet mama will be sad. What's with her precious son in police custody? Stop, please stop. I'm not gonna do anything, I'm just gonna consult with the police. Sorry, Nozu, but I'll testify too. I'll also tell them what I saw. I'm begging you, please don't tell the police. I'm so sorry, I apologize. You wanna know what it said in your letter, don't you? So you tried to steal it. Try reading this. Nozu reads the letter. We already read this, so moving on. Nozu finishes reading the letter. What? I'm not a good guy like that, I'm the worst. Yeah, yeah. Except I'm the worst, so. 15 years ago was the hardest time of my life, but it was also my most cherished memory, that summer festival. Oh no, I forgot about the silent video. Everybody, shh. Soak it in. Soak it in. That's creepy. Let's go to the festival. Oh, it's you guys. Don't scare me like that. His silhouette looks a bit like the bug guy from Yu-Gi-Oh. You know the one? Weevil or whatever the fuck his name is. He has the big glasses and like the alfalfas. Oh, sorry, I got distracted. That has nothing to do with you. All the people in the town don't think that way. As soon as they see my face, they'll start accusing me. We thought so. So we all wore fox masks. This way, no one can tell who you are. Come on, hurry up. The booths will close. Thanks. Weevil Underwood. That's his name, right? Sorry, I got distracted. The seven classmates in fox masks walk around looking at the different booths. Salespeople and passers-by react with surprise. This is pretty fun, isn't it? It's exciting. Like we're pulling a prank on everyone. Like pop stars on a secret date. Bitch, please don't talk. Your channel will expose us. Also, your talking makes my ears bleed. Hey, don't call me bitch. Everyone will notice. They probably will, yeah. That cotton candy looks so yummy. You're always thinking about eating, aren't you? If anyone tries to pick a fight, I'll bite them. Oh my god, they really have one character trait each, don't they? This one likes to bite people, this one's a fat bastard. Monkey's a moron, this guy's a twat. Thanks. Everybody laughs. Shorty and his classmates are walking home from the festival in the dark. They've taken their masks off, but it's too dark to make out their faces. Hey, something just flashed. It's a flasher. It's a firefly. Call the police. It's rare to see fireflies this time of year. For an instant, the forest by the riverbank lights up with a galaxy of fireflies. How pretty. The fireflies take flight all at once. A stream of light stretches across the deep indigo sky. Shorty, Snappy, and Monkey look sentimental. You're Shorty, right? Yeah, I'm Shorty. Ow, stabbed myself in the nipple. Alright, we're out of time for today. Like, actual. So we're going to finish talking to Nozu. And by finish talking to, I mean he's going to tell us nothing. In the next episode. And then we've got one more person to talk to, right? Bestie. And then, hopefully, we'll be done. Thanks for watching, Bruce, and sorry about the really weird quiet bit that I probably will forget to cut out at the end of that silent video. Anyway, thanks for watching, Bruce, and I'll see you in the next one.